Why would you need Open NAT Type on your games? Sometimes you want to play an online game, but your friends can't join you, or the game doesn't allow strict NAT Type to play. Even with moderate NAT, it takes too long to find a game, and you may see some players are very laggy. They can be fixed for any game if you keep watching this video. At first, Open NAT Type in a game isn't the same as NAT Type 1. When you see Open NAT Type in a game, all of the ports that the game needs to use on your internet are open. Consider ports as doors. When you have NAT Type Strict or 3 or EF, it's like you closed and locked all of the doors on your house and you don't let anyone come in. When you have NAT Type Moderate, you let some people go, but not everyone. But when you have NAT Type 1, everyone can join you. And all doors are open, even hackers and thieves can join. But don't worry, you can open the door for the people who want to play with you and close them after they join you. That's when you get NAT Type open in the game. If Call of Duty needs 3 doors of your house to bring players in, you give the keys to Call of Duty so you get Open NAT Type in Call of Duty. However, your house door won't be open to everyone. Let's see how to open NAT Type for a game. The first thing you have to know is this method only works on a house connection like ADSL, DSL, VDSL, fiber, dedicated wireless connection. You can't open the NAT Type on a SIM card mobile connection. But there are other ways for that which you can check from here. Links are also in the comments. The first step is to find the doors or the ports that the game needs to be open. You can go to portforward.com and search the game name. For example, I'm testing Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War. Please scroll down to find the TCP and UDP ports. Here is a list for each platform. I want to open it for PS4, so take a copy of the PS4 TCP and UDP ports. The second step is going to your router settings. There are different kinds of routers, but I will show you 3 examples. To enter your router settings, Google your router name and then put settings IP at the end. My TP-Link IP for setting is 192.168.1.1. It might be different for your router. Connect a device to your router with Wi-Fi or LAN and then enter the IP address in a browser like Google Chrome. You need a username and password for it, and again you can search in Google. It's usually admin by default. Search for the port forwarding option in your router. You can Google it if it's hard to find. I will show you where it is in 3 different routers. In this TP-Link, it's in Advanced Setup NAT, choosing Active PVC. You can find that PVC by going to Status. One of them should have an IP address, and that's what you need. Select Virtual Server. Here I can open ports or the doors for a specific IP. First, give it a name like Call of Duty. Select protocol from port forwarding. For TCP, it's 9035 and 3478 to 3480. I make one for 9035. In the local IP address, enter the console or the PC IP that you want to open NAT Type for it. For example, in PS4 and PS5, you can find the IP by going to Network Settings and select View Connection Status. If you don't know how to find it in your console, Google it. By the way, remember to connect console to the router you are opening ports on it. Save the settings and do the same for the next one. Here I enter 3478 and for end 3480. It opens 3479 and opens other ports in between. Do the same process for UDP ports. Save the settings, restart your router and make sure your console IP didn't change, because in some cases you need to set up a static IP on the console. Now when you open Call of Duty, it shows NAT Type open. To set up a static IP address on your console, you can Google it to make sure it always has the same IP and you don't need to change the local IP every time. There is something called DMZ that this option does to open all ports for a specific device. You can find it in your router for a simple setup and enter your console or PC IP address, save and restart the router. It does the same thing, but this time for all games, and you don't need to do port forwarding anymore. But why the heck did you show us port forwarding? Maybe your router doesn't have DMZ, or you have more than one console and gaming device. That's the case. Finding these options can be a bit tricky in some cases, but if you Google your router model, you will find it. I will show you a few more examples. In this router, I have an option as port port management. It's the same as port forwarding. Or in this router, it's here. And there is another option named UPnP. What this option does is open the ports by request. You see, my PlayStation requested to open these ports. But the best way is to use DMZ first if you want an easy and fast method. And after that, port forwarding and UPnP. And to find game ports, all you have to do is to check portforward.com. If you are a gamer, you know how vital the ping is. That's why you have to check this video next to understand how lower the ping and fix lag by using DNS and VPN. The only tutorial that really helps you to improve your gaming experience. I'll see you there.